Welcome to Tony Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. Please like and subscribe, and please check out my intro video. In 2 minutes, you can find out all about me, where I've been, where I'm going, what my goals are. Also, please check out this painting at the end. There will be a link at the top of the description. Always forget to say that, so I'm not going to forget to say that this time. I put up painting demos and studio tours. Last time, I did one in my series of suggestions paintings. These are paintings that I do by working in an abstract expressionist manner, a strong reaction to colors and textures as I place them down. And then I look around to see if something kind of showed up, which often happens. And then I bring that out. Sometimes I add other objects. This time I thought it was going to be what most people call an abstract painting. I, an artist, and other artists like to call non-objective or non-figurative. But when it dried, I did start to see something. If you look over in this yellow area, it looks like a little girl from behind. And I brought it out a little stronger. And I decided that that yellow area could kind of be like a mirror. And then up here, there's this bird, kind of a strange bird, frontal area of the bird. And I really didn't have to add much, the eye, a little outline. Same with the girl, which I decided would be Alice in Through the Color Glass, or Alice Through Colorland, whatever. And then over here, there was what really looked like a turtle. I didn't have to add much to that either. Just had to add the legs and an eye, but pretty much that's what it looked like. So it's a really interesting series, and I decided I'm going to do another one of those. And this time, I'm going to use a pretty big brush and try to really cover the painting fairly quickly. Then maybe go back in with a smaller brush. Not sure. Like I always say with my YouTube paintings, I really like to experiment. I like to just yak while I'm doing it. And when I yak, some really interesting things seem to crop up. So I'm just going to, again, just start putting down some paint and try to not think too much about it at first and try to avoid that circular motion. As I said last time, I tend to get fish, which is okay, but got enough of those. Like to get some other shapes. Lots of times faces show up, and I always like that. Or just really interesting figures in different positions, and that's always nice too. But I'm trying to not think about anything right now other than just putting the paint down. And then I'm going to start reacting to it as abstract expressionists do, just how the colors are working together to promote a feeling, an expression, an emotion, whatever. I'm sure everyone watching this knows that color is certainly closely related to emotions. And I think that the colors we pick as our favorites relate to our emotional makeup. Now, I'm not in any way an expert on that or anything, but I do think there's a lot of research on that. This brush has a kind of a, the way it is, it's really separating out the paint into lines, which is interesting. I think I'm going to use some more water because it's not going to form anything. Well, it doesn't usually form anything if I'm just using fairly thick paint. It just kind of sits there. Not seeing a thing yet. Gotta watch those spirals, see if I can't just put the paint down. Been such a rough week. I hope people watching didn't have as rough a week as I did. Injured my shoulder so bad I could hardly lift my arm. And something happened to my left eye. Broke those blood vessels. I must have been lifting too much. Didn't even realize I was doing that. And wow, blood all over my eye. Last time that happened, I didn't pay too much attention to it. I just kept going and wow. My whole eye was just covered in blood, and the ophthalmologist said, you have to stop. You have to not do much so it could get better. I didn't realize you could make it a whole lot worse, and I did. So this time I was good. Got behind in my stuff. So much to do all the time, and just got behind. That's just the way it is. And I'm so much better today. Can lift that arm all the way up and not squeal, and that's great. We workaholics, sir. That's the problem with being a workaholic. I love what I do and I work real hard, but God, it's so easy to injure yourself. And I take real good care of myself. As I often say, I do a lot of yoga, and I often complain about it because I don't like yoga, but it does so much to keep your body in shape, so much more than other things that I do to keep my body in shape. I know I have to do that, and you can't do that when your eyes got blood all over it, so I had to stop for a couple of days, but I'm going to get right back to it. I may cuss while I'm doing it, but I know how important it is. Okay, well, interesting things are happening. I don't really see anything, but like I said, sometimes it takes all the way to the end. I'm going to just add some water and let it move around more. Maybe get another brush. Getting some interesting things, though, in terms of a painting. As I said, sometimes I really don't see anything, and it becomes a, what I call, center of my mind, music without words, whatever you want to call it. You either like it because of how it looks, or you don't, but you can't bring in your visual biases. You can't say, well, I like it because it's a ballerina. I don't like it because it's a ballerina. I like it because it's a car. I don't like it because it's a car. You have to just like it because of the way the artist put those colors down and textures and lines and everything. And no, certainly no law says you have to. But I think non-objective art is wonderful. I love it. I love all levels. Representational, abstract, and non-objective. It's all fascinating to me. They're all visual experiences. And it truly is music to me, no matter what level it is. Okay. Well, I really like this, but I'll see a darn thing in terms of any shapes coming out. Lots of times when I'm doing this for YouTube, something really does stand right out. But it's not happening this time. I might change that brush soon. Some of that paint's getting all over my palettes, messing it up. So, I haven't used any white. I think I'll use some white now. Well, I really like it as a non-objective or non-figurative or what most people call abstract. I think I mentioned this before. A friend of mine was writing a book, an Art of Preach book, because he wasn't real happy with the ones we had in our art department at RU, Radford University, where I taught for 20 years. So he decided to write a book, and he said, you know, I'm just going to use the word abstract because that's what everybody does. And that's what people that look at artwork do. They don't really understand those three different levels. I can see what he's talking about. Okay, really getting some nice things going. Don't see a thing. But it's maybe an abstract painting. That's fine with me. I call those my center of my mind's paintings because all my paintings, to me, are abstract. I mean, I can reproduce a photograph, but they're all an abstraction. Abstraction from life, and they're all a creation of mine, no matter how representational, abstract, whatever you want to call it, they're all from the center of my mind. That's why I like to use that term for my abstract. I'm seeing some kind of weird alien type things. That could be a head, some weird things like that. Other than that, I'm not really seeing much. I think I'll get an even smaller brush and pull around and see what happens. I always like to have a lot of contrast in size of the brush marks or whatever shapes show up. So I'll get a smaller one and that's going to happen. I really wish I hadn't gotten so much water in my palette because it's really messing up my colors. Not sure how I did that because I really wasn't using much water. But that's the thing. It's always tricky when you do YouTube, so I'm not going to stop and fix it. So things like that happen. I just go with it. Well, I'm seeing some interesting little shapes coming out of this, but I wouldn't say that they represent anything. But really, I like that way that's happening. So, but as I've often said, it has to dry. The other one, I didn't see anything until it was dry, and then I really did see that little girl, and I just outlined her and decided she'd be Alice. She's almost always depicted as a girl with long blonde hair, when actually, the real Alice, and there was a real Alice, was a brunette. There's a wonderful movie called Dream Child that gives you the story of Alice and the author. She was someone he knew. Knew her as a little girl. Okay. Well, I'm just kind of having fun painting this. Kind of By doing this, I'm getting kind of little flowers or something. There's some depth right through here, that most of it's mostly it's a frontal painting, and that's fine. I tend to love to have abstract paintings with depth, since I like using depth in most of my work. I am going to be doing some work from the park here. Oh, I like that. From a Claytor Lake, because I like to do boats sometime. A lot of artists do. There's wonderful geometric shapes against the water, and the foliage around it can just be a really nice feast of color and texture. So I'm thinking of that. I really like that real strong red I put in. I think I'll put that somewhere else too. Yeah. And I'm going so fast that if there's anything here, I'm not going to see it until it dries. It's been 10 minutes. I don't know if I want to do much more. I think I might just wait for it to dry and then decide if I see anything, because I really don't. I mean, I could make up something, like these little shapes here could be flowers and all, but nothing is really just showing up in the bleeded areas or the areas that are not bleeding. I'm really not seeing any definite shapes, or even nebulous ones. But that's, you know, that's the chance I always take with these. I really like that. See, at this point I'm making a zillion decisions based on what's already happened. I'm analyzing the whole thing and deciding, does that look good with the rest of it? Does it look good there? Is it sticking out too much? Just the same thing as with a representational painting. I would always think about all the shapes and those paintings too. How they're working together. Is there a focal point? Because there usually is. Or is anything sticking out too much? That's it's all very similar to me. I think I mentioned this before, I had a teacher that said that. I said, yeah, it's all the same. And I thought he had to be out of his mind when he was talking about abstract and representational. He said, it's all the same. I thought, what? Are you crazy? And I talk the same way. I used to tell students at Radford that. I would tell them about that teacher and say, see, now I'm talking the same crazy way. And you keep at this for as long as me, for a long time, and I bet you will too. You'll start talking crazy too. It's not really crazy. It's just an understanding of a visual language that is unique. Just like music without words, art is a language too. It doesn't have to have definite shapes to be a very strong language. Oh, I like that right there. That one right against that blue-green, that very pale blue-green, worked real well. That probably sounds really strange. That's okay. If you're a painter, you know what I'm talking about. I don't know. It's getting to the point now where if I keep on, I'm going to lose some of these really nice things. I can see some places that I could turn in to probably some flowers, and I might. I don't know. I might just leave it as it is because I think it's very strong the way it is. Some very nice areas, and I like the way there's not really such a definite focal point, but it just kind of leads you right through here in a nice circular pattern. And circles are great in art, regardless of what types of shapes they are, because circles are unbroken. You know, you tend to follow them, and it holds you there as longer. And that's certainly what artists want, is they want you to be involved in this visual experience for as long as possible. So lots of times they do use circles to keep your attention, to keep you moving around the space. All right, I think I'm going to lose some stuff now. So I think I'm going to quit. So thank you very much for watching. As I said, there will be a link to the final painting at the top of the description, a link to my Etsy site, my website on Wix, and please check out my blog. That'll also be in the description. I'm putting out a blog post every day.